Hey everybody, thanks again for watching my channel, and today I figured I start a new segment on my channel called The Story Behind the Video. And in this first segment, this first video, I want to talk to you about Meatloaf 2003 I Couldn't Have Said It Better concert tour. And as you can see on the video, the concert tour had a specific opening. It was just for a short while that Meatloaf was brought on by two nurses, strapped on in a hospital bed, and even the crowd didn't know what was going on. And there is a story behind it. There is a story behind this video, but before I tell you the story, I need to say that the entire opening segment of this concert will be shown directly after this introduction. So if you keep watching, you will see the complete opening. The video was taken at London in December of 2003, and just a month earlier, in November, also in London, also in the Wembley Arena, Meatloaf had to cancel his concert halfway through because he was not feeling well. He had to stop the concert because of medical conditions.
Ladies and gentlemen, I apologize to you at this point in time. I have been suffering from the flu for over 10 days now, and I really, really wanted to come and perform for you tonight.
We love you.
They didn't want me to, but I did. And ladies and gentlemen, I apologize to all of you right now, but I am in no time, really. I'm sorry. I really cannot go on. I'm terribly, terribly sorry. I love you all.
And that was a problem this tour. Meat had some health issues, and for those of you who are aware, Meat was eventually diagnosed with the Wolf Parkinson White syndrome. And the Wolf Parkinson White syndrome is a heart condition, and basically it means that there is a problem with the electrical system of the heart. Meat was suffering from this, but during that time and during the cancellation of concerts, and especially when he had to stop the concert in London, newspapers were running wild, especially the Boulevard Press. And Meatloaf always hated that, but they were printing the most ridiculous stories about his health condition. And that is the reason why, when he returned in London in December, a month later, he figured, you know what, I'm gonna give them something to write about. So he came up in a hospital bed, stripped in a hospital bed, left behind by two nurses, Patty and Cici, of course. And that was the intro of the concert. He didn't do it for the remainder of the entire tour. He only did it for a short time. I believe also because of the reaction of the audiences, who weren't completely sure what to think of it. But that's the story behind this remarkable concert opening. Let's watch the footage, and thank you for watching.
Thank you. things that happened only yesterday. I was barely 17, and I once killed a boy with a Fender guitar. I don't remember if it was a Telecaster or a Stratocaster, but I do remember that it had a heart of chrome and a voice like a horny angel. I don't remember if it was a Telecaster or a Stratocaster, but I do remember that it wasn't at all easy. It required the perfect combination of the right power cords and the precise angle from which to strike. The guitar bled for about a week afterward, and the blood was zoo, dark and rich, like wild berries. The blood of the guitar was Chuck Berry red. The guitar bled for about a week afterward, but it rung out beautifully. And I was able to play notes that I had never even heard before. So, I took my guitar and I smashed it against the wall. I smashed it against the floor. I smashed it against the body of a varsity cheerleader. Smashed it against the hood of a car. Smashed it against the 1981 Harley Davidson. The Harley howled in pain. The guitar howled in heat. And I ran up the stairs to my parents' bedroom. Mommy and Daddy were sleeping in the moonlight. Slowly I opened the door, creeping in the shadows right up to the foot of their bed. I raised the guitar